I'd like to take a few minutes now to celebrate World AIDS Day, December 1st, that we celebrate every year for the past 25 years. And it really is designed to commemorate the battle against HIV and particularly celebrate those who've lost that battle and to talk about the hope for the future. Over the past 30-some years, we've made great, great progress. That being said, we should never become complacent. There are still more than 35 million people in the world who are infected with HIV, and still nearly a million die every year. In Ohio, last year, there were close to 1,000 people who were found to be newly diagnosed, not necessarily newly infected, but newly diagnosed. And that's an important statistic for us because as we find people who are infected and we can get them into care and treat them, we can really minimize that transmission. We've made great progress, too, because of all the clinical trials that have gone on. I remember a time when we had no medicines to treat HIV, and then we had multiple medicines that people had to take multiple times a day with multiple side effects. And now we have several options for one pill once a day that can control the virus and allow people to live healthy lives. So with that being said, I think we really need to take a moment and pause to commemorate those who have died, but to celebrate those who are living healthfully and successfully with HIV, and to remind all of us that it's important to take care of ourselves and be safe and get tested.